get it my picture on the show. Why does it have my picture on it? Oh, that's my Jesus.
Hello, everybody. Nice to see you. I'm running for mayor of the city of Boston for the simple reason that I love helping people, and that I think city government is the way that we can work together to make Boston better. I've got the best background, the most experience to let me lead from day one, to hit the ground running like nobody else can. Any questions?
Tell them about your rubber sidewalks.
Everybody loves my proposal for rubber sidewalks. So one of the first things that I'm gonna do is this, I call it, it's a low-tech, high-tech idea that is so simple, but it's gonna really help the city of Boston. Now it sounds silly, rubber sidewalks, so don't laugh. We have a problem in the city, all over, from South Boston to Reedville, where we plant trees and sidewalks. And then we pour cement over those trees. And what happens in about 2 years? The roots of those trees push the sidewalk panels up like this, and they make the sidewalks impassable. We have hundreds of locations around the city where pedestrians, people in wheelchairs, the elderly, parents pushing strollers, can't get down the sidewalk. And what we found out is there's cities all over the country using a technology called rubber sidewalks. It's ground up tires, literally old tires that can't be used anymore, that get ground up. They get formed into the shape of a sidewalk panel. They get dyed the color of a sidewalk so they look exactly like it. And then they're interlocking. So what we'll do when I'm mayor is, to solve this problem, we'll take this rubber sidewalk technology, the panels lock around the tree base, so that when the arborist has to come fix the root, he doesn't have to hire a company to jackhammer it out, he just pops it off. But the amazing thing, the reason that the roots are pushing up the sidewalk panels is not because they're growing, it's because they're in search of water. When we bury them with cement, they don't get the water they need to get the proper nutrients. So that's why they're pushing it up, they're pushing the cement away. Rubber sidewalks are permeable, the water goes through it. The roots never again push the sidewalk panels up. Problem solved. We talked about public safety, and I want to bring 10 new technologies into the city to make our city safer. One of them is the most basic idea that's being done all over the country, and we're not. It's to get police, fire, and EMS to an emergency quicker. And wouldn't that be a great thing if you had an emergency in your house here, in your development, and you're waiting for an ambulance or you're waiting for the police? It's called emergency vehicle preemption. Here's what other cities are doing. They take a transponder and they put it in the front of a fire engine, a police car, and an ambulance. Then they take another transponder and put it in all the traffic signals. So that if the police, if a fire engine or an ambulance has to come to this development and they're driving down, let's just say, Broadway or in Hyde Park Ave, which is 5 miles from Reedville to Jamaica Plain, or Center Street in West Roxbury, which goes from Dedham Line all the way to the Faulkner Hospital, they would be able to turn all the lights green as they're traveling and turn all the side streets red to give them the straight shot without having to slow down at intersections and speed up, slow down, speed up. So they're gonna get here quicker, and at the same time, they resolve the conflict at the intersection so that they're not getting into accidents, which we have a lot, police cars and other cars that when they get to the intersections get into an accident. Now, under this technology, all the lights turn green. We're gonna reduce response times, no more accidents, save the taxpayer money on buying new vehicles, but most importantly, get police, fire, and EMS to emergencies quicker. It's being done everywhere, it's not being done here, and we should do it, and it's awesome technology that's very inexpensive to do, and we could do it if we made it a priority. So those are two examples of ideas and technology that a forward-thinking city could use, and that's something that we're gonna do as mayor. Keep bringing these innovative best practices from other cities to our city to let us do our job better. So, thank you. Yeah. Anybody else?